This is a video explaining how to conduct a site survey with the Larson Davis 721 or 821 sound level meter. Before we get started, let's briefly discuss what a site survey is. A site survey involves taking multiple sound measurements at specific locations to form a sound map. The locations where sound is to be measured are combined to form a map that the operator will follow while taking sound measurements. The locations are typically numbered 1, 2, 3, and the sound measurements at each location are typically of the same duration and time. Sample site survey. Our example site survey is a manufacturing plant with 4 locations to measure. Each location will be measured for 1 minute. The 4 locations are 1. Cubicles, and this is an office environment exposed to the factory and manufacturing area. 2 is packaging, that's the top left corner of our map. 3 is receiving, and this is the bottom right corner. And 4th is manufacturing, and this is the general area left on the map. I am going to demonstrate this process so you can get a feel for how it is done on the meter. Let's say we are at location 1 and are ready to make our measurement. We simply press the run button on the instrument and wait for the instrument to stop automatically after 1 minute. Once the instrument has stopped, we can move to location 2. Make sure not to power off the instrument while changing locations. Now we are ready to measure at location 2. Once again, we simply press the run button and wait for the instrument to stop automatically after 1 minute. This process can be repeated until all the locations are measured. Once we are finished measuring all locations, hit the store key to save all locations or measurements to a single file. This simplified measurement process is made possible by the measurement history firmware of the Larson Davis 821. The measurement history firmware allows each location to be measured with the individual metrics while still providing overall metrics for all locations and allows each location to be measured individually, providing summary metrics for each specific location. So how exactly does measurement history work? Each measurement is presented as an individual row in the results file. A new measurement is made when the run key is pressed. The default behavior is set to stop on store, which automatically saves the measurement when the stop key is pressed. However, we would like multiple measurements to be stored in a single file, so we disable the stop on store function feature. Now at the end of a measurement, the meter will be in a stop state and wait for the user to either 1. Hit the run key to start a new measurement because we're at a new location, or 2. Hit the store key to save all pending measurements to a single file. Since we are conducting a site survey, after the meter completes the current measurement, we will move on to the next location and hit the run key once we are set up at the new location. Once we have measured at all locations, we will hit the store button to save all of our measurements to a single file. Configuring the instrument to make a site survey. First, we're going to tap the blue settings button on the meter screen. And then under measurement, we are going to select measurement history and change this to 6 hours. Now we're going to go under system and we're going to disable auto off by tapping on the X/checkmark toggle. If you turn off the 821, it will always store data to a file. This is unlike other Larson Davis sound level meters where you can turn off the meter and then turn it back on and continue the measurement. In order to get all the site survey measurements into a single file, the user must make sure not to turn off the meter in between measurements. And this is why we disabled the auto off. Now we're going to go into the mode control. We're going to disable store on stop by tapping on the X and checkmark toggle. Now we're going to enable the time stop feature to make each individual metric the same duration. This is not required, but it is recommended. In our example, we're going to set this to 1 minute. This is all that is needed to configure the 821 to conduct a site survey. Now we are ready to get measuring.